Wizards can be anywhere.
Hi, I'm JD. I'm one of three founders of Witchfish Studios, a game company currently working on a multiplayer Crazy 8-style deck builder. In our game, every player draws a hand of cards. One card is pulled from the deck to be played on. Going around in a circle, every player can only play one card from their hand if it matches either the suit or the number of the card on top. If you can't play, you must draw a card. The goal is to empty your hand of cards so you have zero left. At the beginning of each round, players each choose one special card to add to the deck, hence the deck builder aspect. For right now, these special cards are simple draw two, skip, and flip directions. Eventually, these cards will be crazier, having drastic effects on you and your friends' hands. As the game goes on, you'll be crafting your own custom deck that's slightly different each time you play. You'll be able to form synergies between your hand and the deck and sabotage your friends at the same time. In the previous Devlog, you got to meet the team and learn what role we each play within Witchfish Studios, along with learning about the tools that we use. This time, we want to focus on what we've been doing over the past 2 weeks to make this game our own. In the first video, I mentioned that we follow a methodology inspired by Scrum. I want to go a little bit deeper into our process now so that you understand what makes our process a little bit different from some other studios. Every 2 weeks, we start what we call a sprint. A sprint's a specific period of time that's dedicated to meeting certain goals. So at the beginning of every sprint, all members of the team meet up and discuss what we think we can accomplish within the 2 weeks. We call these goals user stories. The point of user stories is that they're focused around the ideal audience for your product. You're writing the goal from their point of view. If our goal was to make a devlog aimed at other game developers, the user story would be like, as a curious game developer, I want to watch other studios' videos about their development process so that I can improve my own. If our primary goal is to attract an audience that will buy the game, it would be something like, as a gamer, I want to learn more about Witchfish Studios' game so that I can decide if I want to buy it when it comes out. Writing these sentences instead of make devlog one forces us to remember our end goal. The end goal isn't to just make any video, but to grow an audience for a game or to educate that audience about the processes that we use for game development. Once we have our user story, we break it up into tasks. The tasks for devlog one are write the script, record clips from the engine, record the voiceover and video, and get all of these materials to our editor. Since the editing isn't done by me, Jeffrey, or Hunter, we don't put that on our task list. Now that we're on the same page about these words that we're using, we can dive into what we've accomplished since last time. We finished our first sprint successfully, meaning we met all of the goals. We implemented the core features so that our game is currently in a playable state. It's not finished by any means, but we want each sprint to be playable by the end of it. You can draw cards, hold a playable hand of cards, play special cards like plus two, skip, and flip, and the game ends when one player either completely runs out of cards or the deck runs out of cards before anybody can win. This is Crazy 8s with a few special cards, which is exactly what we want as our foundation. Since then, we've had a focus on making the game our own. This game is going to be a deck builder, so players need to be able to actually build up the deck. We implemented the feature to be able to choose a card that can be permanently added to the deck. Right now, all of these cards are special cards. Since each player can add one card at the beginning of each round, that means that the deck gets four cards bigger every single round. After implementing that first feature, we really wanted to start nailing down what the game looks like visually. We needed to decide on a theme, and we had a few different options, but really, we could hear a small little voice still haunting us from Snatch and Sniff, a game we had made earlier that year together.
Wizards can be anywhere.
So, that was simple. The game's about wizards playing a magical card game, probably in a tavern. Beautiful. With this theme decided, we want to begin making the game look cohesive. This is hard, because we don't always know how things are going to look until they're implemented into the engine, but our artist Sam has helped a lot by putting together a style guide. We call this style guide Wizard Grunge. To begin implementing this style guide and add important readability into the game, we want players to be able to see their opponents and see how many cards they actively have in their hand. So we did that. Jeffrey made this really nice container that automatically organizes cards inside of it so that every player's hand is accurately represented by how many cards they have. They also gently float, because the players are wizards. Duh! Speaking of, the opponents now have wizard hands. A big visual change we needed to make for the game's theme to feel more genuine was the card deck itself. Having these basic cards has worked really well for testing, but in order to have a vertical slice done by the end of summer, we need to nail down what we want these cards to feel like. We went through a lot of sketches until we landed on these. To go with the magic theme, each suit is represented by one of four elements: earth, wind, fire, or water. For special cards, we have a fifth suit we call void cards. Then, to beef up the deck a little bit more, we wanted to add some more special effects. We added in the burn cards we talked about last time, so now cards can be removed permanently from the deck. This card burns the card it is played on top of. We also added a new type of card functionality called on-draw effects. If you draw a card with an on-draw effect, that effect will take place instantly, whereas the other card effects only take place when you play the card. So if you draw a +2 on-draw card, you will draw two additional cards on top of the one that you just drew. These cards are only slightly different, but having both options will make the gameplay a lot more versatile. Since we had some extra hours to work but didn't want to add another huge user story to our workload, we also added a title screen. Magical Manifest is not the final title by any means, but it makes for great filler. So yeah, 2 weeks later it looks like a completely different game. We're constantly making improvements to unify the visual style along with making the gameplay more interesting. By breaking up our goals into 2 week chunks, we're able to make consistent progress. The biggest struggle of this whole project will be implementing multiplayer, but to lift one burden at a time, we have made a bit of a roadmap for ourselves. By the end of this summer, we will have created a vertical slice that we covered last time. This means we'll have any questions about our game rules, style, and core mechanisms completely answered. If we can complete this, it makes production way easier and allows us to publish a single-player demo of the game so that people can play it, test it, and we can get their feedback. Then, during production, we'll be making this project multiplayer along with adding the rest of the game features that were cut from the original vertical slice, so that the final version can be played by you and a group of friends. By the end of pre-production, we'll be able to tell you how long we think that will take, but for now, we're just going to keep adding the most important features, updating you all on it, and enjoy the process of making a game together.
I think it's working as intended.
I think so.
Yeah. Awesome.
Like a funny face. Like in my head I see like a clown face, but that doesn't make any sense, so I'm not gonna say we should do a clown face, but this is good code.
Yeah.
I mean, this is ugly. Well, it's not ugly necessarily, it's just not right, but we expected that. But the ones on the sides look good.
Yeah.
In the end, working on this project has been so much fun for all of us, and we genuinely love doing it. So thank you for watching and supporting us. We'll be back soon. Bye!
Okay, here is my first go about with silly wizard voices saying, and I quote, wizards can be anywhere.
Wizards can be anywhere. I hope you know that. Wizards can be anywhere. Wizards can be anywhere.
I'm just saying it now. You wanted three? Sorry.